Yo, what is up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video from the Sports Scoop. And today, we have a new series coming back at you. We're going to analyze every single NFL team for the 2020 season, talking about players, offseason, draft, and their overall record. To our first team we're doing today is America's team, the Dallas Cowboys. As we said, we're going to be talking about their players, offseason, draft, record and overall how we think they're going to do in the 2020 NFL season. So if you guys enjoy, make sure to keep watching. Peace. What is good, YouTube? Welcome back to the Sports Scoop. As I said before, today we are analyzing the Cowboys for the 2020 NFL season. If you enjoy sports content, all sports, make sure to drop a sub and a comment for any other videos you want to do. As you said, this is a new series, so definitely give us feedback on if you like it, if you want to keep watching it. The Dallas Cowboys, let's get straight into it, talking about their players. But let's talk about last season. So, Serge, what do you think about their last season?
Well, last year, Dallas went a pedestrian 8-8. So right around average for Dallas, it was definitely a disappointment. I mean, when you look on offense, they have so much talent. A very good quarterback, I believe, in Dak Prescott. Two 1,000-yard receivers in Michael Gallup and, of course, Amari Cooper. Then you got Ezekiel Elliott as your running back and one of the best offensive lines in football. And they ranked second in offensive efficiency last year. However, they were only able to go 8-8, not even beating the injury-riddled Eagles last year, which led to the firing of head coach Jason Garrett and being replaced by Mike McCarthy. Dallas is definitely hoping for a better year next year, and I think it's definitely in the realm of possibility. I think they had a very good offseason and draft.
Yeah, I just think last year 8-8 really not. First of all, that division they were in was just not a very good division.
Definitely one of the worst in football.
Yeah, I think they definitely underperformed. I think 8-8, there's a lot of problems with that team. I think Dak's a good quarterback, but I think he's a bit overrated. He has one of the best, if not the best, offensive line in the league. I think if you have that and the young quarterback, he is the mobile quarterback. He should be able to bring his team to 8-8. And then I know a lot of people, as they fired Miles Garrett,
Jason Garrett
or Jason Garrett, sorry. I always mess up names. Jason Garrett, I think, yeah, obviously the head coach has a big reason of a team's success, but I feel like Dak is also a player that you need to definitely hold accountable for that. So I think this year, I think it'll be a rebound season, and hopefully it is, especially drafting CeeDee Lamb. So Serge, let's talk about some of the players. Let's talk about Dak Prescott this year. What do you think he needs to improve on, and what do you think he needs to keep the same as last year?
Well, this is a tough one. I think he's definitely got to be he actually put up very good numbers last year. He threw for I don't know how many yards. I think he was second in the league in passing. A lot of touchdowns. I think what he needs to improve on is maybe if he wants to be a great quarterback, I think he might want to lower his interception total a little bit. I mean, he started off, it's weird because as a rookie, he was flawless at that. He barely threw any interceptions. I think he definitely had a very good year last year, but I think he still needs to improve that interception category. Also, I think he's got to do more in clutch situations. And he's definitely got the potential to. He is a good quarterback, and I do believe he can perform in the clutch. But I think still some of that has to be attributed to Jason Garrett. I think his coaching did somewhat hold back Dak Prescott. I think with Mike McCarthy and his new passing style aerial attack, I think definitely that's going to give Dak Prescott much more potential this year. So, and I think he can definitely do it.
Yeah, I think Dak Prescott is definitely bashed a lot because of a couple of bad games and last season. I think, yeah, he definitely has potential to be a great quarterback and one of the good quarterbacks. But I feel like having the weapons this year, I think if he doesn't perform this year, it's definitely going to cause some dents in his career. I think this is the year for them to really boost their chance at playoffs. I think they need – I think playoffs, if they don't make it that this year, definitely some changes will have to be made. I think – incredible receivers, a really good rookie receiver who fell to them late first round, which is not expected.
Talk about that later.
Yeah. And also Zeke. So I think maybe getting a bit more of and I'm not saying he doesn't have a big arm, but definitely trying to get more of one, because he's going to have to probably start passing deeper routes with Amari Cooper, Michael Gallup, and CeeDee Lamb, all players that are able to burn receivers and go up for the ball deep down the field. And then I think with Zeke, maybe get some more dump offs to Zeke when he doesn't have options. So I think he has everything he needs around him this year: good offensive line, a better head coach to play successfully. And I think if he doesn't, and I think he will, but I think if he doesn't, that's definitely going to be a disappointment for all Cowboys fans. So let's go to another player, Amari Cooper, wide receiver traded from the Raiders 2 years ago. I think last year was great. I mean, he's a really good receiver. He's the number one receiver and played like it. And I think this year he just needs to play the way he did last year and maybe step up a little bit more, because he's going to have a rookie receiver and produce, make CeeDee a really good receiver. But I think it could be down here for Amari Cooper if CeeDee Lamb turns out to be a really good receiver and Dak starts to give the ball to CeeDee. Also, Michael Gallup should have one of the better years he's had this year, as he's been showing every year. He's a really good receiver and an underrated receiver and a force to be reckoned with. So I think Amari Cooper, I think he'll do well. And I think that's not really doubt. I don't think anyone's doubting that at the moment. So, yeah, Serge, what do you think about him?
Yeah, I definitely agree. I still think Amari Cooper will have a good year. And if so, what if his numbers drops? As long as he makes an impact when he does have the ball, that's all that's important. In fact, I think his role might become even bigger, drawing double teams so that either Lamb or Gallup, whoever's open, they'll get the ball. And obviously, all three of them are capable of winning one-on-one. So, maybe Cooper's numbers may drop a little this year, but honestly, I think you'll be helping his team just as much this year.
Yeah, I agree. Let's go to our other offensive player for the Cowboys. So I feel like that's where their main playmakers are, and I know on defense they have some good players. But so Ezekiel Elliott, their running back, who I personally am not too hot about. I think he's good. I think he's a bit injury prone, and I think I like him, and I think he's a top five running back, top six. And I think last year he played well. Definitely a good running back, good fantasy running back as well. So I think if he just if he can get the ball as much as he did last year, then he's definitely going to produce the same and or higher. But I think it's just there's a lot of players to feed on this team with those three receivers, as well as Dak sometimes choosing to run the ball, like go out of the pocket. So I think Zeke is definitely going to need to ask for rushes, and he's going to need to produce well on rushes and get yardage. And then as well, I think he's going to need to be able to get open for dump off from Dak if any of those two receivers aren't open, which is definitely unlikely. I think Zeke's gonna play well next year, and I don't really have too much doubts about him. Sorry. I don't have too much doubts about him. I think he's a solid player. And I think if he can stay healthy, he's definitely a very, very good running back. Serge, what about you?
Yeah, I definitely agree. So last year he didn't play quite as well as past 2 years. His streak of two rushing titles in a row ended. But that's fine, I think. But although expect, again, is his numbers aren't going to be the same as those past 2 years. As Dallas is going to, under McCarthy, is going to, and Kellen Moore is going to go into a more passing-oriented scheme. Don't give me – I think Zeke's definitely going to have to improve as his ability as a pass-catching running back. So, and I think he's definitely got the potential to do so. I think he still has he's still always going to be a threat in the backfield. And if Dak does – have an off night, so what? Then you just feed the ball to Zeke, and the Cowboys are still always a threat because there's so many guys you have to account for. But again, Zeke's numbers aren't going to be the same due to the system. But if he does improve his abilities as a pass catching back, I think he's going to still be maybe even more of a threat than last year.
Yeah. Okay. So that's now let's move on to the draft and off season. So I want to touch on the draft quickly. If you guys are new to the channel, we've done a lot of draft kind of oriented videos towards rookies and players. And so as you guys know, as we've talked about endlessly, the CeeDee Lamb pick, as we have talked about in this video, I don't want to touch too much on it. I as I said, I just think he's not going to play as well because of the amount of high rate players are on this team. And so that's a kind of pick. That's the main pick that they had this year. So I just think if you guys want to have a more in-depth, definitely go watch some of our other videos. That's all I have to say. Serge, do you have any other rookies you think are going to stand out? I know Trayvon
Diggs. Well, before I go on that, I really I think I like CD Lamb pick. I think definitely again numbers won't be incredible for what he's expected, because again he's playing with Lamb and I meant Gallup and Cooper, but I still think he's gonna have a really good impact, be an impactful player, because now defensive coordinators are gonna be sweating having to guard three very good Cowboys receivers, which again he might be. He's going to be a threat. I think at least for the first half of the year, he's going to be guard probably one-on-one, because I think more of the attention will be going to Cooper and Gallup, and they're going to force the young rookie to win 1v1s, which I think he will be able to. He's a very physical receiver. He can go good jump balls. I think he's definitely going to – early in the year, he could tear it up. He might slow down as defensive coordinators might go zone in on him, but I think he's still going to have an impact throughout the entire year. Now, I think for the rest of the picks, I like the two cornerback picks of Trayvon Diggs and Reggie Robinson. I think definitely after the loss of Byron Jones, that really hurts the team. Diggs fell a little bit, stock fell a little bit as the year progressed, but I still think he's a very good cornerback. He could end up being a really good number two behind Ouzier in secondary and Robinson as well. I really like the Neville Gallimore pick on the defensive line. It could be an anchor in a few years for that defensive line. And lastly, I love the Tyler Biadasz pick from Wisconsin. It's ironic because although the offseason was going really bad, I think in my opinion it was going bad, especially after the Travis Frederick retirement. So what a perfect way to get his replacement by getting another center from his alma mater, Wisconsin. I think Biadasz has the potential to be. Travis Frederick's shoes are very, very big shoes to fill, but I think Biadasz could definitely be a great man in that rotation.
Yeah, I agree. I don't have much else to say. I think the Trayvon Diggs pick was another ceiling on the draft, dropping, I think, one of the better cornerbacks in the draft. Obviously not as good as TJ Henderson or Jeff Okuda, but I think he definitely could have snuck into the first round. So yeah, I think now let's kind of grade their, like, in terms of, now let's go to their free agency, not huge free agent moves. They signed Gerald McCoy and Hawkland Dix. Those are the two main players, and I don't want to talk on that too much. Gerald McCoy, I think he's a good defensive end. He's a very experienced one in the league, played with the Buccaneers for I believe just shy of 10 years, and then was with the Panthers last year and now the Cowboys, and I think he's going to be a 1 to 2 year player they'll keep. He's going to get 5 to 6 sacks, and I think he's going to improve that defensive line with DeMarcus Lawrence. And yeah, I think pairing up with Neville Gallimore, I think they'll have a good defensive line. And that with the Hawkland Dix signing, I think Tobin Heath losing him to free agency, Hawkland Dix fills in a safety need. The problem with him I see is that he has been moving around a lot, been with a team for more than 2 years, been with a new team, a team for 2 years, like for more than 2 years, for 3 years, because he was on the Redskins, then to the Bears, and now, I don't know if that makes sense.
He was on the Packers first.
The Packers first is what I meant. So I don't want to touch too much on that free agency. I don't think it was a big free agency. So I guess so Serge, draft, off season, what do you think?
I'm gonna touch on free agency for a sec. I didn't think Dallas's free agency was very good, and off season would have gotten a very good grade from me if it wasn't for their great draft. But again, Gerald McCoy, I think it was a bargain of a price. But the reason why they would have signed him is if they believe they can make a deep run in the playoffs. It's nice to have a veteran presence, but I don't know if he's gonna even start on that D line. Hawkland Dix, a little bit, I don't know, he's kind of same level as Jeff Heath, but it's an okay pick. But again, I think it really hurt for them to lose two players. for them to lose Robert Quinn to the Bears and Byron Jones, of course, one of the best cornerbacks in the league, to the Dolphins. So that really hurt. But again, they really patched up those holes in the draft. So I, not really much to complain overall for that offseason.
Yeah. Okay, so let's – now we're just going to overall talk about if we think this team is going to be better next year or worse. I'm going to say – I think you have to say. I think they'll be – it's hard to say because I think their defense has gotten slightly worse. I think Trayvon Diggs is not going to be able to fill the hole that Byron Jones had there. I think he can definitely in the future. I think Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, I'm not – he gets interceptions. I'm not too hot on him, though. I think he's was a good safety at the Packers and then kind of lost some of his talent as he moved around several times. And then for the Gerald McCoy signing, yeah, it's good. So I think that they will be better on offense. So I think overall they'll definitely probably get better. I think the record will go up a couple more wins. So I think overall they got a bit better, but it's nothing astronomical for the Cowboys. Serge, what do you think?
I think they're actually going to be a lot better. I think one of the biggest changes is Mike McCarthy as the head coach. He's obviously got that winning mentality much more than Jason Garrett. I think the Cowboys have a lot of star power on that roster. And again, this is as the NFL has grown older and older, it's become more and more of an offensive and passing league in particular. And I think definitely the Cowboys have one of the best passing attacks in the league going into this year. And defense, yeah, won't be very good. I don't think it's going to be great, but it's not going to be as bad as everyone expects them to. And I think the Cowboys might end up averaging over 25 points a game. Yeah. And I think I expect them to go 11-5 with their record. And
yeah, again, so let's get not to the record next. So you have 11-5. For their record, I'm going to give them a 10-6. I think they'll have two more wins. I think 2 years from now, I think depending on how they play next year, will be their year to potentially go for Super Bowl. Yeah, that's going to wrap up the video. That's all we wanted to talk about. If you guys think we should add anything else about the teams that you guys want to see, definitely make sure to leave a comment. As I said, make sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. We're almost to 1K. We hit 600 today, I believe. So thank you guys so much for that. So yeah, definitely make sure to check out more videos because we'll have this series. We'll have about probably like 3 to 4 teams a week, and we'll try and get those videos out to you guys. So make sure if you enjoy them to leave a like. Yeah, that's been it from us. Thank you guys.